Hi, welcome back. Till now, we have studied the basics of insects morphology, anatomy, and systematics. Having thorough knowledge of these three aspects, now it's time to move on and study the general characters of orders and economically important families. As per the Christensen classification, there are 31 orders now. So we'll be studying the distinguishing features of all these 31 orders, and wherever more number of species have been described and families have been identified in each of those orders, we'll be studying the distinguishing characters of economically important families. And as a source of literature, I have taken the information from Borer and DeLong's Introduction to the Study of Insects by Triplehorn and Johnson, The Insects of Australia, a textbook for students and research workers. These two textbooks have been widely used for identification to the family level across the globe. And the third book which I used is General and Applied Entomology by V. Vasantaraj David and T. N. Anthakrishnan. So in the lecture number 4, I'll be covering the distinguishing features of non-insecton hexapoda, which is also called Entognathus hexapoda. So I'll be, keep on putting this slide almost in every class from here onwards in all the systematics lectures, so that this new classification will be firmly fixed in your mind. That is the intention. So the superclass or epiclass hexapoda consists of two unranked groups, Entognathus hexapoda and Ectognathus hexapoda. Entognathus hexapoda consists of two classes, class Helipura, which consists of order Protura and Columbola. Class Diplura consists of order Diplura. So in this class, I'll be covering the distinguishing characters of these three orders. The class Helipura and Diplura can be distinguished with the help of this character of respiration, wherein the class Helipura mostly respire through a cuticle. So they have got cutaneous respiration. However, few of the species also have got spiracles. But now mostly all the individuals belongs to this class have got cutaneous respiration. They respire through cuticle. Whereas the class Diplura respire through spiracles. They possess spiracles. So let us look into the distinguishing feature of each of those orders. We'll start with the order Protura. They are commonly called Proturans or tails and tiles. The terminology Protura etymologically arrived from Greek word pro or prot means first. Ura means tile-like structure. Okay, so they possess tails and are tile-like structure, hence they are also called tails and tiles. So that's how etymologically the order Protura is derived from. They are very small, minute insects with 0.6 to 1.5 millimeter in length. And the eyes and antennae of these Proturans are absent. Okay, they do not possess eyes and antennae. So basically, antennae is meant for sensory function. So in fact, that sensory function is taken over by the forelegs, which are all the time projected forward on the sides of the head. So as the antennae are absent, forelegs performs the sensory function. And abdomen is 11 segmented with a terminal tile-like structure, which is called telson. Out of these 11 segment, styles or finger-like processes are found on the first three segments, which are mainly meant for locomotion. So in addition to the thoracic legs, they also possess finger-like processes which helpful in locomotion, which are present on the only first three abdominal segments, which are called styli. So these are the important distinguishing features of the order Protura. Coming to the growth and development of Protura, they undergo anamorphosis. What is this anamorphosis? Once the egg hatches from the egg, the first instar larva, which is called juvenile or also called pre-larva, which possess 9 abdominal segments. Okay, this pre-larval stage will have 9 abdominal segments. When it molts, which reaches to the stage called larva first, which also has got 9 abdominal segment, but in addition to 9 abdominal segment, there will be tile-like structure, which is called telson, which is not there in case of pre-larval stage. So this larva 1 molts and reaches to the larva 2 stage, which will have 9 plus 1, that means 10 abdominal segment. What happens here? Larva 1 and larva 2, there will be addition of abdominal segment. Okay. So larva 2 will have 10 abdominal segment plus telson. When this larva 2 molts, there will be one more addition of abdominal segment. So adult will have 11 abdominal segment plus a tail-like structure or telson. So this type of addition of abdominal segment during growth and development at each molt is called anamorphosis. So anamorphic or anamorphosis is nothing but addition of abdominal segment during growth. Okay. Whereas all the other stage, all the other insects except proturans will not now possess this type of now life stages wherein addition of abdominal segment takes place, which is called epimorphosis. Okay. So anamorphosis is nothing but addition of abdominal segments during growth and development, whereas epimorphosis means there will not be any addition of abdominal segment during growth and development. So only Protura will undergo this type of anamorphosis, whereas all other insect orders undergo epimorphosis. Coming to habit and habitat of Proturans. Proturans live in moist soil, humus, leaf litter, underbark, and decomposing logs. That means they feed on organic matter, and few of the species also feed on fungal spores. So mainly these Proturans feed on the decomposing organic matter. Worldwide, 816 species have been described, and from India, approximately 20 species have been described from three families. So that is the status of number of species described worldwide as of now. Coming to second order, order Colambola, they are commonly called spring tiles. Etymologically, the Colambola is derived from Greek words. Colambola means colle, means glue. Embola or embol means wedge or bolt or bar. Okay, so primarily now because of some of the abdominal appendages which are found, these terminologies have been derived from. Colambolans are very small insects with 0.25 to 6 mm in length, and this is the order which possesses lowest number of abdominal segments. So abdomen is 6 segmented. So very important, remember abdomen with 6 segmented. So among the insect orders, the Colambola possess lowest number of abdominal segments. And they possess eye patches. So they are not exactly Ommatidia. In fact, they are analogous to Ommatidia. They are called eye patches. They are present with 8 plus 8. That means laterally they are found now 8 in number. On the other side, 8 Ommatidia. And many species are blind, in fact. And they possess appendages in the abdomen, and they are called pulafore or ventral tube, retinaculum or springing organ, which is also called furcula, which is a forked organ. So these abdominal appendages are found in first, third, and fourth abdominal segment. So out of 6 abdominal segments, 3 segments possess appendages. The appendage found in the first abdominal segment is called colophore. Okay, in fact, the term Colambola is derived from this colophore, which is also called ventral tube. Third segment possesses another appendage, which is called retinaculum, also called catch. The fourth appendage bears one more appendage, which is called furca or furcula, which is also called springing organ. So, colophore is found in the first abdominal segment, which acts as an adhesive organ. So, whenever they move, moving on the smooth surface, so this colophore helpful in adhering to the surface. In addition to the adhesive organ, it also performs the additional function of excretion, respiration, and also it provides lubrication to the legs for grooming. So that is the function performed by this colophore found on the first abdominal segment in the ventral side. Similarly, on the ventral side, on the third abdominal segment, it bears another appendage, which is called retinaculum, which holds the furcula when furcula is not in use. So this furcula is found on the fourth abdominal segment, which is a Y-shaped structure, forked organ, helpful in jumping. Okay, whenever this furcula is not in use, it is projected forward and captured with the help of retinaculum, which holds the furcula. So when the insect is ready for jumping, the insect actually pushes the substratum and jumps. Okay, so that's how furcula is helpful in jumping. So those are the important functions performed by these three appendages found in the abdomen. Coming to habit and habitat of Colambolans, They mostly feed on decaying vegetable matter, fungi, and bacteria, whereas some of the species are carnivorous. Most species live in soil, leaf litter, under bark, decaying logs, or other decomposition habitats. In fact, they are actually susceptible to disturbance. Whenever the soil is disturbed because of various human activities, the populations get dwindled. As a result of that, the colombolon population can be considered as indicators of soil health. So when the soil is rich in decomposing matter, the population usually increases. Or whenever soil is disturbed, the population get reduced. That's why they can be considered as indicators of soil health. Few species lives in freshwater pools, along seashores, on vegetation, in termite and ant nests as inquilins, caves, snowfields, and glaciers. So they are adapted to a wide range of habitat. As a result, more number of species have been described around the globe. 8,163 species have been described worldwide, and 299 species from India across 19 families. So that is the species described across globe as well as from India. Coming to another order Diplura. They are commonly called two-pronged bristle tiles or diplurans. Etymologically, the term Diplura is derived from Greek words. Di means two, also diplu means two, ura means tile-like structure. So tile-like structure is sarsi modification, which may be long or sclerotized. Coming to important features of order Diplura, antennae moniliform, which is weed-like. Eyes and ocelli are absent. Okay, so most of the non-insect and hexapoda are blind as they live in soil. Abdomen 10 segmented with styli found on the abdomen segment 2 to 7. Okay, and sarsi are present, which are variously modified. Okay, it may be long, unsclerotized, or very short, or sclerotized. Okay, so that's how we can distinguish different families of order Diplura. Okay, it may be long and unsclerotized, short and sclerotized. Coming to habit and habitat of Diplurans, they live in groups or in small colonies. Few of the species are found in ant nests and termite area as inquilins. Food of Campodids, family Campodidae, they are mostly vegetarians, they feed on vegetation. But Japagidae are carnivorous. They wait buried in soil with only the forceps, that is sarsi. Okay, wherever the sarsi are sclerotized, they're considered as forcep-like. So these sarsi are found exposed, and whenever the other arthropods are found moving, okay, they capture with the help of this hard sclerotized sarsi and they devour. Okay, so that's how they become carnivorous. Okay, worldwide, 975 species have been described. And in India, 18 species from 4 families. Coming to collection preservation of these non-insect and hexapodans, mostly all these Entognathus hexapoda lives in soil. See, Protorans lives in soil, damp places under stones, decaying wood. Colombola, mainly soil, moist conditions of soil, leaf litter, surface of fresh and marine water. Again, Diplura, mainly soil. Okay, so that means all these three orders are abundant in soil. Then how to collect and preserve them? Okay, as they mainly live in soil. It's very difficult to collect small quantity of soil and look for these minute specimens. They are very minute specimens. They are microscopic specimens, in fact. So as a result of that, you need to collect the soil and extract the specimen from the soil. So these three orders of insects can be extracted with the help of an equipment called Burley's funnel. So this Burley's funnel is mainly made up of a light source and a funnel wherein we can put required amount of soil. And these insects are photophobic, as they live in soil. So when you put on the light source, these insects, these Entognathus hexapodans, they start moving away from the light source. And they get collected in a container where we need to put 70% alcohol. So these insects have to be collected directly to the 70% alcohol, otherwise they get degenerated very soon. So This funnel, in fact, consists of a mesh. So insects, they move through the mesh and they get collected in this container, which consists of 70% alcohol. So once they are extracted, these specimens have to be preserved permanently in 70% alcohol. Okay, so then only they can be used for taxonomic identification. So we'll end with this lecture with a few questions. Which is the oldest fossil insect? In fact, the oldest fossil insect belongs to one of the three orders which we studied. What is external fertilization or indirect sperm transfer? Although we did not discuss about the external fertilization or indirect sperm transfer, if you go through further about these three orders, you will come across the meaning as well as the which non-insect and hexapoda undergo external fertilization. Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much. I look forward for the questions. If any, you can post below or you can email me as well. Thank you. Thank you very much.